sugar.
Nice. So uncomfortable.
Oh, come on, Scott. I don't want you to think of me as your new dad. After all, we're fraternity brothers first.
This is so weird.
Just think of me as your big brother that's marrying your mother. Wait, hold on. We're brothers who share the same mom slash wife.
If you hate your boss, here's the remedy. Step up in the building with the big dick energy.
Pixar movies are considered to be some of the highest quality blockbuster anime and movies to ever exist. But what is the ultimate Pixar movie? Introducing the Ultimate Pixar Tier List.
For the next film in the Ultimate Pixar Tier List, we go back to school in Monsters University. This is Pixar's first and only prequel, and it takes Mike, the sidekick in Monsters, Inc., and turns him into the protagonist, and makes the film all about his dream to become a scarer. Does this film succeed in telling a compelling Mike story, or does its nature as a prequel hold the film down? Firstly, I want to say I genuinely really enjoy Monsters, Inc. It is one of my favorite Pixar films. I put it at high A for a reason, almost got into S tier, and maybe in the readjustments it will. We'll have to see that, that's for a different video. But regardless, I love Monsters, Inc. So the idea of more Monsters, Inc., unlike more with Cars 2, is something that is appealing to me. Making this film a prequel, however, is an interesting decision, and one that I think on paper isn't terrible. And in a lot of ways, I think some of this film justifies that very, well, reason of existence. However, I think most of this film doesn't make up for what the film is trying to do. Genuinely speaking, if you were to ask me if I like Monsters University, my answer would be I think it's a very alright film. I think it's fine. I think it's fine. However, I think this film is just way too cliche and generally forgettable for me to excuse it of saying that it's just fine. I think it's just a little bit below just fine. But it does have things about it that stick out, which makes it just really hard to rank and think about, place, all that. Let's start with the characters. I think Mike in this film is really good. I think actually the idea of making a prequel and then starring a side character is typically what prequels do. Usually the main source has its main character's story begin and end. In the first film, that is Sully. And Sully does have some moments here, believe it or not. But except for one real moment, the POV of this film is entirely through Mike. And I think that is interesting. I think his character is really good. I think that him and Sully are very interesting. The dynamic is fun to watch. And I think that overall his arc, as in theory, is really solid. And I think that I think that Mike is a character that makes this film, you know, not completely suck. I'll just say it right, or just be straight up honest. I think that what they use Mike for is to explore someone who has these wild, ambitious, lifelong dreams, yet they don't match the typical image of that dream. They may have the will and the mind, but they don't have the physical necessities needed. I think this film actually may be a allegory for disability, and if it is, it actually does a pretty good job with that, I think, because Mike is capable in some ways, but in the world and the standards that the world of monsters, or the, of the monsters, live in, Mike just doesn't fit that abled, you know, preferred physical body. But yeah, I'll talk more about that when I get to the themes. But I think Mike is a pretty solid character, as is Sully for the most part. Together, they kind of do what they need to do, and I think they're pretty good. I wouldn't say they're as compelling as Sully is in Monsters, Inc. I don't think there's any relationship that even comes close to, let's say, Sully and Boo, for example. But I, genuinely speaking, really like those two. The side characters is where this film loses me. Almost all the side characters are either one-dimensional, forgettable, or both. Mostly both. I think the dean of the school is the one that maybe sticks out a little bit, but mostly because of what they do thematically and in some plot points. As a standalone character, they provide very little, which is a shame because the first Monsters Inc. had so many good, memorable side characters, and their designs really made them stick out. And in this case, their designs are not all bad or uninteresting, they just don't do enough for me. I think the biggest sin of this film is Randall. I hate Randall in this film. I hate what they did with him. He starts off as this very nerdy friend of Mike, and then it's revealed that he has this like big twist and turn in the evil, and it does not shown off screen. It does not feel earned. And they also use his try to use his character to like explain how he acts in Monsters Inc. Like in Monsters Inc., there's scenes where like he clearly can't see very well, and it's plot convenience and why he doesn't see Mike and Sully with Boo throughout the film. They explain that in this film by Mike being like, "Hey, you look better without your glasses." So he takes off his glasses and goes like, "I can't really see, but I'll wear them anyway." It's like, "All right, bro." Like, you had to explain that, or this the even worse part near the end of the film, during the end of the scare games, where Sully and Randall go after each other, go against each other, and Sully does so well that it fucks up Randall, and Randall has a line of like, "I'll never let you win again, Sullivan." And it's like, all right, like, you need to explain that? Those kind of feel like they cheapen the moments of Monsters, Inc. Like, not everything needs to be explained and shown so regularly. That could have just been a relationship that just existed naturally from working together. But no, everything in prequels has to be explained, and that is my least favorite parts of prequels. Luckily, this film doesn't do it that much, but I fucking hate when prequels have to explain every single thing and give extra meaning to every little thing, and then it just dampens and cheapens moments in the original film. But regardless of that, this film doesn't have much of that, but Randall is a representation of that, and I hate him for it. The voice acting in this film is incredible. Like, seriously, one of the best Pixar voice casts. Like, actually, as good as Monsters, Inc., and it's Monsters, Inc. was already that good, and it has a lot of the same voice casts, but even the new ones, you got Nathan Fillion, you have so many phenomenal voices. I think the voice cast in this is super fucking solid. Like, really, really good. So I gotta give the film credit to that. The soundtrack, not as good as Monsters, Inc. It's hard to do that, but it has some of the motifs of Monsters, Inc. in there, and it adds a lot of songs that have, like, college band style, like the drums and the horns. So I like that. I think the OST is creative in its setting. But speaking of setting, this film loses me there. Just the concept of Monsters, Inc., having monsters go to work. Again, I explained in my Monsters, Inc. video how genius that concept is. Having monsters go to school is just a little less interesting. I don't know. Like, we've seen going to school, this person going to school, a lot. Very rarely do you see, like, workplace films with such a wild concept. But, yeah, the school setting is just not very interesting. It's really, a lot of ways, doesn't even feel like college. Maybe, like, on the surface. But, like, how characters act and how the setting and world acts feels a lot more like high school with its drama and its cliques. Like, I don't know. Like, it feels just like a high school story with a university backdrop. Whatever. Regardless of that, the setting is not nearly as interesting because of the concept of the doors aren't as prevalent, or the corruption, or so many different elements of the corporation, how big it is and vast it is. And we see a bit of it in this film in the beginning, in the middle, and the end. But no, the university just simply isn't that interesting. I can't even really, I can picture, like, maybe some scenes in the quad or some buildings, but, like, there's no real that. The only interesting set piece I can really think about in this film takes place through one of the doors. Like, it just, there really is very little to play with the setting here. The first film did such a good job with, not even through the doors, but just corporation itself was just way more interesting than the university. Just, yeah, not that interesting. Now, the themes of this film are good, especially in the third act. I actually like how they build up Mike to, he's going to become this scarer, he's going to do all this stuff, and he's going to be someone who may not fit the prototype, but he is going to make it through hard work and dedication. And then he doesn't. Well, he does, but they cheat. He realizes that he may have the will, he may have the guts, but he's just not that scary. And ultimately, well, he tries to go to a campground to prove himself, and he can't. And he has this, like, great discussion with Sully, and they both kind of talk about their anxieties and their insecurities. And Mike comes to the realization of, like, I can have all the willpower and all the knowledge, but I don't have that. I don't have it. And the film ends with them getting kicked out of the university, and I was like, oh boy, here we go. They're gonna get let back in, and that's how they're gonna get the Monsters, Inc. And no. He has to go to the mailroom, and he has to work. And they work their way up. And just generally speaking, I thought that was really, really cool. I like that sort of ending. I like that twist on Mike's character. I think it's actually pretty good. Generally speaking, yeah, I think Mike's arc in this film is really solid, especially the twist at the end. I love the campground scene. The set piece is awesome. Again, the discussion between Mike and Sully by the lake is so good. And yeah, I just think the third act of this film is actually is easily the strongest part of this film. However, there are still acts 1 and 2. And my biggest problem with this film is, fuck, it is so predictable and it is so formulaic, and by the books, it hurts. I know at this point I've talked about how I like Mike's character arc and I like the third act. And I really like the subversion there, because it's a prequel. You think you know what's going to happen, and in a lot of ways you do. But I like how they subvert your expectations, and you know, it kind of is unfortunate that you know he doesn't end up becoming a scarer and is just Mike's sidekick, but it shows him how Mike and Sully depend on each other and their relationship. And again, I think a lot of it's very formulaic and cheesy in the first and second act, but to see how the relationship form in the third act and to show how, you know, that twist is so good. But again, first and second act, bonk it the fuck down. The second act especially is atrocious. Like, it is really, really weak. They have like the scare games, and it's just so, the scare games are dragged out way too long. You have so many different events and all these things going on, and it's just like very formulaic. By the book, you can see it coming. You have the moment where Mike and Sully have to get a team together, and then they fail the first game. Oh no, it's over. Oh, someone cheated, so they keep going. And then they have moments like that where it's like, oh, they get invited with the cool kids. No, it was a prank, and now they feel sad. All these things happen. The only part where it gets subverted at the end where they cheat, because it makes you feel like I gotta give them credit, because at the end, Mike does succeed by cheating, and it does not reveal they cheated. And I genuinely was like, this is so fucking stupid. This is awful. What is this? And I can't believe that I saw everything for this film coming and I did not see this twist. So that was actually pretty well done and pretty well earned. I gotta give them the twist, because they did build it up with Sully mentioning it early on, the foreshadowed it, hinted at it, and even built it up with him at the one time we get his POV. While he's trying to make Mike scary, he has this look on his face. He's like, we're gonna lose, and he knows that they're gonna lose, so he has to rig the system to do it. And it's fucked up, but it makes sense. But no, the second and first act of this film feel way too easily predictable, by the books, uninteresting, forgettable, and just safe. Like, the first Monsters, Inc. was not safe. It took risks in its storytelling, even though it wasn't, at least formulaic-wise, anything crazy out of the ordinary. But at the very least, I just feel like this film plays it way too safe, and you just see everything coming. It's like a basic college story that's been told a million times again, and the film, until the third act, has nothing unique about it. You know, even its concept has been done in Monsters, Inc. This film has nothing unique about it until the third act, which, again, I will praise the third act. I like it. I think it's good. I think it, just like Brave had a good first act. Like Monsters University has a good third act. But its first two truly just are not that good. They're not bad. There's no point where I think this film is really awful, terrible. It's just whatever. The humor, the jokes. There's a few that are funny. Most of them are very whatever. The plot points, the themes, the characters, whatever, whatever, whatever. It sets up a lot of good things in the opening, which I really like with Mike, and then answers them in the third act. But the rest of the first and the whole second act feels like getting there, and it's not interesting until that subversion, like I said, with the twist with Sully cheating in the whole third act. The first and second act just are just so honestly boring and just forgettable. Yeah, there's really not much else to say. I just really wish that they did more. I made the scare games more interesting, or shortened them, or just did other interesting stuff and ideas. They just didn't really explore it. And I think that has to do with the setting and its backdrop, just generally speaking, not being that interesting. So, yeah, I really gotta say, I think they really dropped the ball in a lot of ways on this film. I don't think that it's bad. It's just sort of conceptually generic. That's a good word to say, generic. Monsters, Inc. is anything but that. And this film falls into the same traps a lot of prequels do. I have a lot of problems with prequels in that, not because I see where things are going and I'm like, I know where things end, but because a lot of prequels feels like it has to lay a lot of pieces in order to match up with the original, it limits its story capabilities. It limits how much risk it can take, what direction it can go, and the wild and wacky things it can do. And that's something I feel like this film absolutely suffers through. I don't need to be shocked and have this twist in every film, you know, with this plot. And this film actually kind of does that, despite it being a prequel. Even though you're like, you still think, oh, they're going to let them back in, he's going to become a scary. Even though you know that doesn't happen, it's cool to see that doesn't happen. And they get in there a different, foreshadowed, interesting way. But it's not that the plot points are predictable that make, which it is, that makes this film so bad. It's just that its plot points are predictable because this film doesn't really have a strong, unique, interesting story besides Mike's. And even that, they take a long time to do it. And it's a story that really isn't that long. There just need to be more here. Setting, conceptually, all that stuff. Just, yeah. This film's not bad. This film is not bad. It's not F tier. It's just a little bit below fine. I wouldn't say this film is average. I'd say it's a little bit below average. Just because the first two acts, especially the second, really drag that much. They really are that uninteresting. And I wish this film was better. Because I like some of its themes. Again, I like the third act and Mike's character. But yeah. Not quite. Not quite. But where am I going to rank it? Well, Monsters University, in a lot of ways, is a very bland film. The film is often way too safe and by the books, with every plotline being so formulaic and cliche that it can get old quick. The second act in particular drags, and the scare game plot is so uninteresting and runs for way too long. However, the third act and the film's ending is actually pretty good. I like the overall messaging and the wrap-up of its themes, even if the film fumbles around setting it all up in the first two acts. The school setting is way more generic and conceptually less interesting than the work setting in Monsters, Inc., and the film's best conceptual moments are based upon the foundation set up in the first film. While Monsters, Inc. is one of the funniest Pixar films, Monsters University simply isn't relying on its humor and feels lazy at times, and insultingly bad at others. The film never reaches awful, but rather often hangs as predictable and safe, only its final set piece and ending being interesting. The voice acting is spectacular, and the cast is all star, but the characters outside of Mike and Sully are uninteresting and very forgettable. And generally speaking, one of the least interesting Pixar group of side characters. Outside of one scene and its ending, Monsters University never really takes any initiative in telling a super compelling story and falls into some writing and plot traps, holding the film down from being as creative and as incredible as it can be, even if its protagonist and his story isn't that bad. Monsters University hangs right into a D tier. It is better than a film like Brave, but with a really bad second act, its good third act can't save this film from being a below-average Pixar film. It's a run-of-the-mill film, but for a Pixar film, it feels a bit too uninspired, despite some of the film's highlights. A part of me wanted to put this film in low C, but I think high D is just more acceptable, because as a film, I think it's a C-tier film. As a Pixar film, it's a D-tier film, because I hold Pixar films to different standards. This is not a film tier list, it's a Pixar film tier list. And for a Pixar film, Monsters University just, it's a D-tier. It's much better than something like Brave. I think Brave is like D, borderlining F. Monsters University is D, borderlining C. But I can't put it in the same tier as something like Bug's Life, because, yeah, it just is a lot weaker in almost every single way. But we have to move to our next film, Inside Out. We are going to be watching this today during Monsters University when this video comes out on Twitch with you guys. I'm very excited for that, but I might take me a bit to do this video. I have a lot of stuff coming up with filming, scheduling stuff, and a lot of stuff outside of work and stuff, so I may not have time to put this video together for maybe 2 weeks, so I may take a week off. Keep an eye on my Discord and stuff for more information on that. Either way, I'm still watching it today, and I guess I should talk about it. I am excited to see this film. I have seen this more than once, unlike the last three films, all of which are DNF tier films. I have all only seen once. This film I've seen twice. I saw it in theaters, and I saw it at home. I own it on Blu-ray. And yeah, I'm excited to get back to this film. I think Inside Out is, we'll see what I think of it. I'm not too sure. But I'm hoping it does more than the last couple of films. I think conceptually it isn't the most unique idea, but at least it sounds somewhat interesting. But I think it is a little more bold in its execution. But it has been a while since I saw it. I saw it in the theaters, and I saw it like a year later on Blu-ray. So it has been, you know, like 6 years or so since I've seen it. We'll see what I think of it. I don't know. I'm excited to get to it. But we're going inside a child's brain. Ah, that is a evil, evil place. I was a child once. Fucking child's head is evil. Children are evil. That's what I'm trying to say. Children are evil. Watch Toy Story. Children are evil.